We've got lots and lots of these baby food pouch caps. And previously I built a automatic catapult that shoots these things. And I've also built a rubber band crossbow that automatically aims and shoots. So the challenge to myself is to make some kind of hopper feeder for these things that feeds them one at a time. And this was my first experiment. The wheel is supposed to pick up a cap out of the bunch every time it goes by. But the problem is, if there isn't a cap that is in the right orientation, it doesn't grab one. Here it's got one, but see, it's picking up other ones ahead of it. The problem is this wheel is way too small, so I made a bigger one to try it out again. So this doesn't always pick up because there might not be a cap in the right orientation on the bottom. And so to agitate that a little bit, I glued this little bit on there, which will stir them around and hopefully flip some of them around. So there, it's got one that's the right orientation. Another one. Another one. And this time, I kind of missed. So this kind of worked. I added a second notch, added a second agitator, and made a stand to figure out what's the best angle to hold this at. So I think I need to change it a little bit more this way, and I also got to keep caps from falling at the bottom. More this way. With the release much more near the top, all these extra bits will just fall off. So this is working surprisingly well, except for pieces getting kicked out right here, so I need more barrier. Oh, missed one. I gotta test this running at a constant speed without hand turning it. Oops. Wrong gear. I think my feeding contraption works adequately. Now I just need the catapulting part. These three pieces are going to make up my rotary catapult. With both pieces kind of working, now I just need to figure out how to get the caps from the feeder to the shooter, and I was initially going to put both of those on the same shaft, but that involves a complicated chute to get the caps there. So I figured instead to put the shooter right where the caps come out of the feeder, but that involves some gears to power it. I'm just gluing these bits together with hot glue so I don't have to wait for the glue to dry, and I can't be bothered with CA glue and activator and all that stuff. I was much too much into this to film it all of yesterday, but I'm getting to the point where it might work. So here's my rotary catapult, and the stop for that is down here. So if I have a cap that is down there, it shoots it out. And the wheel, this wheel is going to bring the next one up, and then shoots it. So I just need to get the phase right. So let's see, this comes up here, drops it in, falls down, and not too early so it doesn't fall at the bottom. And the next one. Whoops, I should change the aim. It doesn't pick up as reliably as I'd like it to, but the caps all seem to end up in about the same area. And now with a dedicated AC motor. I think that runs a bit too fast for my pickup to work properly. This motor looks identical to this one, but it's like a different gear ratio on it. And I've got this hooked up now so that I can run it. Except the gears are a little bit out of phase right now, so I gotta fix that. So I need to drop these a little bit earlier, so just gotta tweak that a bit more. I'm still disappointed with how many times these slots come up empty. I'm thinking maybe I should change the shape of this agitator to flip those caps around a little bit better. I'm hoping this ramp will flip more pieces. Uh-oh. I got a problem. This ramp is just the wrong distance here where it can jam a cap in there. So let's see if I can pry this off and re-glue it somewhere else. Closer to the edge this time. It really has a hard time getting those last few loads. Oh dear, and those are stuck good now. I changed the other agitator to be less of a ramp so that it can carry pieces like that up and flip them over, and that seems to be much better at clearing out the last few caps. There we go. I added a mount for the motor and hid away the electrical stuff in here. Plus a light bulb in series, this is kind of an overload protection. So if the machine stalls, the bulb lights up and I know it's stalled. And I still have enough power for it. Plus I hot glued a few extra bits of wood on here where some of the caps were escaping. So this is now ready for testing with the kids.
Wait, stop!
And Rachel wants my next project to be a little bit more useful.